The move seam command under edit curves is a way for you to control the seam where a closed periodic curve joins itself. Now, this might be a little bit tricky to actually see on a curve, so what I'm going to do is create a circle, which, as we know, by default, is a closed periodic curve. And we're going to go to Surfaces, Extrude. I'm going to, let's do this at Distance. I'll specify the axis. We'll do this up in Y, an extrude length of about 2. And we'll extrude that. So that's going to create a little ring of a surface, like so. And this surface has a seam. You can see it because it's the thicker isoparm. Incidentally, this coincides with the actual seam of the curve. Now, just to show you how this works in relation to a surface, let me select this. We'll go to Shading. I'll switch on Wireframe on Shaded so we can see that seam at all times. Now, watch this. I'm going to select a curve point along this curve. Let's say over here. We'll leave the seam in view, but we'll just kind of select a point here underneath our surface off to the side. We'll go to Edit Curves and choose Move Seam, which has no options. What this is going to do is relocate the seam of our periodic surface, a periodic curve, to the point that we have designated. So when I click, boom, everything moves around for a moment. Now check it out. My seam is over here, and if I check out Control Vertices, my seam has now been relocated. That's all there is to it. It's just a way for you to take the seam of a periodic surface and move it around. And this operation also will pop up later on under the Edit NURBS section right here. So that'll wrap it up for this video. Thanks a lot.